Good morning, children. So already we have learnt about the vegetation and all those things, climate conditions, isn't it? Now let us go for the life of people. How the life of people is carried on in Saudi Arabia. Conventionally, Saudi Arabia was inhabited by nomads who used to keep moving from one place to another in search of food and water for themselves and green pastures for their cattle. Means what? Earlier in Saudi Arabia, you could see people, only the nomads. Nomads means wanderers. Who are these nomads? They will be wandering from one place to another in search of food, water and all those things. Not only for themselves, they even was going to search the food for their animals. Pastures, green pastures for their cattle. Say they were growing this livestock, isn't it? Livestock means the animals they were domesticating the animals. These animals also require food to eat, isn't it? So they were not only going for search of food for themselves, they were going in search of food for even their animals. So that's the meaning here. See, conventionally Saudi Arabia was inhabited by nomads. Nomads means wanderers. They did not have a settled life. They never had a permanent house. They were moving from one place to another. These people are called as nomads, who used to keep moving from one place to another in search of food and water for themselves and green pastures for their cattle. These nomads thrive in many parts of Saudi Arabia even today. So even today, though it is fully modernized, it is civilized, even there, now also you can see in some places these nomads are there. Means the wanderers there, they do not have a settled life. So these nomads thrive in many parts of Saudi Arabia even today. They generally live in tents made of animal skin or coarse cloth. So normally they live in the tents because they have to move from one place to another place. So they cannot carry their houses. So what happened? They have got tent, and this tent is made up of what? Animal skin or coarse cloth. Coarse cloth means the thick cloth, like canvas cloth we say, no? That a thick cloth it is. So that they carry wherever they move. Now, see, it is made up of animal skin or coarse cloth, those tents. The nomads of Saudi Arabia are called Bedouins. So, the nomads are called as Bedouins. The names are Bedouins. See, the nomads of Saudi Arabia are called Bedouins. So, the nomads means the wanderers are called as Bedouins. See, the Bedouins indulge in rearing livestock and move in groups, forming long rows of camels. So what do they do? When they finish in one place, they want again in search of food. No, they will be moving in group. And not only group, they are carrying their animals also along with them, especially the camels. How they move? They move in rows. You would have seen that also in pictures. How the people will be moving in a line, the same way even the camels also will be moving along with them. Understood? So the Bedouins indulge in rearing livestock, means they domesticate the animals and move in groups, forming long rows of camels, because they are moving there in the desert areas. So sometimes they will be on the camels, some people will be sitting on the camels, especially those who cannot walk. Those who walk slowly, they will be moving. Camels also, you see, they walk slowly, they don't walk fast. Okay, even running is also not that fast. Now, these groups of people, they are normally traders or pilgrims. Traders means what? The people, those are doing business. Okay, those are called as traders, and pilgrims means the people who are visiting the places of worship. Places of worship, temples, mosques, churches and all that. Those people are called as pilgrims. Especially they move, they visit the temples. So these groups of people means the nomads, Bedouins. What do they do? They are especially traders, businessmen or people who are going for worship. Traveling together on camel back across the desert are called caravans. So there are people who, this especially the traders and pilgrims, what do they do? They move on the back of the camel. And this group of people who are moving on the back of the camels are called as caravans. They are called as caravans. So the Bedouins sell and buy animal products. See, what do they buy and sell? Why are they called traders? Because they buy and sell animal products. So from animals. Now, sometimes it may be milk, sometimes it may be the skin part, sometimes it may be the bone part. Okay, all these are for the animal products, and from that they make some dishes.
So the bedouin sell and buy animal products, dates,
dates, khajura, you know. So this in desert areas normally you see this dates. Then food grains, food grains, especially I told you where it is grown, in the oasis part and the valleys part, where there is availability of
water. So food grains etc. at the village marketplace
to earn their livelihood. So they go to marketplace. How do they go? With the help of camels. They sit on the back of the camel and they go to market and get the food materials, whatever they want.
Many people have begun to settle near oasis and practice farming. So most of them make their houses where near the oasis. What is oasis?
The water spot in desert areas are called as oasis. And they, what do they do? Because there is presence of water, isn't it? They can use for irrigation. So desalinated water, they use the desalinated water. So they remove the salt content from that, and that water will be used for farming purpose, for drinking purpose and all those things.
So they make their houses from sun-dried bricks.
So how do they make their houses? By the sun-dried bricks. So they make the sand dunes, you know, from the sand mud they collect, and they just make it into blocks and they leave it for sunlight. So what happens when the sunlight falls on that? It becomes into blocks of bricks.
So they use this sun-dried bricks. Small villages develop in such areas.
So like that many people are joining together and they make their own houses in one area, especially in the oasis region, that itself becomes one village.
Understood? Now coming to religion, language and dress. Islam is the official religion of Saudi Arabia and the people here are Muslims.
So the maximum number of people here are Muslims. They follow the Islam religion.
The official language of Saudi Arabia is Arabic.
So they use the Arabic language. For communication they are using Arabic language.
Men generally wear a long ankle length cotton robe called thob and a headgear called gutra, which protects them from the excessive heat of the sun.
So they have got the long gowns. You have seen the priest in churches. They use a long gown, you know. The same type of gowns will be used by men. And they use a headgear. See, headgear. There will be a cloth and there will be a, like a thread, it will be tied around this head.
So what happened? Men generally wear a long ankle length cotton robe called thob and a headgear called gutra, which protects them from the excessive heat of the sun.
Why? Because they are directly exposed to the sun's light, isn't it? Sun's heat. So it will be protected.
And what do the women do? Women wear a long black robe called the abaya and keep their head covered with the hijab.
So like burqa, what you call burqa in here in Karnataka, and all we call burqa, no? Muslims wear, no? The same type of dress will be worn by the ladies. Okay, so gents have a different dress and ladies have the different dress.
Now coming to economy. Economy means what? The money matter, financial matters. So economy, the economy of Saudi Arabia is petroleum based.
See, mainly they get money from petroleum products.
It is the world's leading exporter of petroleum.
Leading exporter of petroleum means what? It will transport the petroleum products to different countries. So when our country is transporting materials for different countries, we call it as export. But if our country is buying materials from other countries, then we call it as import. When we get it from other countries, it is import. When we give it to other countries, it is export.
So here what happens? They have the petroleum products that will be sold to different countries. So they are a very good exporter of petroleum. For the development and modernization of the country. See here, the money earned from the export. What are they exporting? They are exporting petroleum, isn't it? So the money earned from the export of petroleum is being wisely used for the development and modernization of the country.
So what is happening?
They are developing and modernizing.
Means now no more it is like nomads. They are not going to be wanderers.
They are moving from place to place to stop. So they want to have a settled life.
So what is happening? That is the settled
running only by modernization of the country. So they want to be like a modern people, not like this old tribal people. So this modernization they are getting through money from where? From exporting of petroleum products. Coming to industry, so you can see the main industries of Saudi Arabia, petrochemicals, because petroleum is very much rich, you know, there in Saudi Arabia. So the main industry of Saudi Arabia, petrochemicals, iron and steel, then petroleum refineries, fertilizers and cement. So all these industries are there now at present. Earlier it was not there. Now they have started because they are modernized, isn't it? They are civilized, they are modernized, they have got a settled life. That is why all these things are present there. They have got these industries itself there. Which are? Petrochemicals, iron and steel, petroleum refineries, fertilizers and cement. Small scale industries of leather, soap, processed food, means packed food. Processed food is packed food. Handicrafts, means they make so many craft work. And textiles, means our cloth industry. Textiles are also present. Small quantities of bricks. Tiles, bricks means it again. No, tiles. Tiles for the walls and for the floor and all those things. Tiles. Furniture. The table, chair, desk and all those things are called as a furniture. And pottery. Pottery means what? Made up of mud. What you call? Madike. Pottery is madike. All these things are produced in this country. Which country? Saudi Arabia. So that means it's totally modernized. It means it is getting all the products. Earlier it was not available. So now they have already modernized, they have civilized it and then they have extended. So desert is coming down. Understood? Land is increasing, it is expanding. Coming to important cities, Riyadh, Jeddah, Mecca and Medina. See, this Mecca and Medina especially, it is a very good pilgrimage place for the Muslims. So how you say about Kashi Yatra, isn't it? The same way these people, the elderly people, what they do, they go to Mecca and Medina. So if they go to Mecca and Medina, no, all their sins will be washed and they will be treated as a very great person. So that is called as actually Hajj. They go for Hajj. So how you say Kashi Yatra, that we call it as Hajj for Muslims. Especially which place? Mecca and Medina. So this Riyadh, Jeddah, Mecca and Medina, some of the modern cities of Saudi Arabia. Riyadh is the largest city as well as the capital of the nation. So capital of Saudi Arabia is nothing but Riyadh. Mecca and Medina are two holiest cities. So two holy cities. Which are there? Mecca and Medina. Already I told you, know, Muslims, especially the elderly people, they go there for worshipping. Because they feel that they are, you know, the Muhammad prophet, he was the founder of this Muslim, that is Islamic religion, Muhammad prophet. So his belongings are present where? In these two places, Mecca and Medina. For that reason, most of the people visit there. Understood? So these are the two holiest cities, which are Mecca and Medina. The busiest seaport of Saudi Arabia is in Jeddah. So busiest seaport, seaport is present in Jeddah. It's a very big airport. Sorry, seaport, not airport, seaport. Coming to transport. Once Saudi Arabia was mostly uninhabited, as much of the nation's land consists of desert. So, uninhabited means you could not see life at all earlier. Why? Because totally it was covered with desert area. Understood? Fully sand and fully hot. And night it is cold. So, people were not staying there. So, there was no life. Earlier, uninhabited means people were not there. But today, many people from all over the world go to Saudi Arabia to work. See, even from India also so many people are going to Saudi Arabia. Why? Because it is one of the richest countries. They can earn good money there. For that purpose, many people from around the world go to Saudi Arabia. See, but today many people from all over the world go to Saudi Arabia to work. This has become possible as now the nation has modern means of transport with a good network of roadways, railways and airways. So earlier it was only they have to depend on sheep and other livestock, isn't it? But now what happened? They have extended that and expanded this area. They have already constructed the lands. So you can see roadways, railways and airways. The country has developed rapidly over the past few years. So very fast it is building, it is growing. This Saudi Arabia is growing very fast. So the country has developed rapidly over the past few years, and the once barren land, desert was a barren land because there was no vegetation, no water sports. It was barren. Means what we call it as marubhumi. You are not able to grow anything there. But now what has happened after this expansion? See, and the once barren land has become quite productive. So now due to expansion, now they are able to grow anything. The government and people of Saudi Arabia have intelligently used their resources to develop their country and raise the standard of living of the common man. So the government also has tried, as well as the people still staying there also, what they did? They started expanding their land and cultivating many things. So like that, what happened? Now this Saudi Arabia is no more like a desert. It has become like a normal city. Understood? So everything is got there. And one of the richest country also. It is one of the richest countries in the world, Saudi Arabia. So children, let me stop it here. We'll continue in the next class. Thank you.